topic is frequency domain specification. Before that, we want to find the magnitude and phase of second order system. Consider the transfer function of second order system, Wn square by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. As we are using sinusoidal for all frequency response, so substitute s equals to j omega. Wn square by j omega whole square plus 2 zeta omega n into j omega plus omega n square. We know that j square equals to minus 1. So substitute in place of j square minus 1. Next step, taking omega n square as common. And next step, 1 by 1 plus j of 2 zeta omega minus omega square by omega n square. On replacing, 1 minus omega square by omega n square plus j into 2 zeta omega. Substitute in place of omega by omega n, x. T of j omega equals to 1 by 1 minus x square plus j of 2 zeta omega. Our main aim is to find magnitude and phase. It is in the form of a plus jb, that is complex form. The magnitude for complex equations is root of a square plus b square. Magnitude equals to 1 by root of 1 minus x square whole square plus 2 zeta omega whole square. Phase equals to tan inverse of b by a. Complex equation is in denominator, so we want to substitute minus tan inverse of 2 zeta omega by 1 minus x square. These are the magnitude and phase equations of second order systems. Frequency domain specification. The first topic in this is resonant frequency. It is indicated with WR. Definition. It is the frequency at which maximum magnitude occurs. If we draw a graph between angular frequency and magnitude, whenever we are getting maximum magnitude, then at that point, whatever frequency is there, that is called resonant frequency. That is the corresponding frequency associated with maximum magnitude is called resonance frequency. Before we derived equation for magnitude, m equals to 1 by root of 1 minus h square whole square plus 2 zeta h whole square. For maximum magnitude, slope equals to 0. So we want to differentiate magnitude with respect to h. We will get the slope and we want to equate the slope to 0. Square root is in denominator. So if we write the equation in numerator, we will get minus whole power 1 by 2. D by dh of, it is in the form of x power n. So n into x power n minus 1. Minus 1 by 2 into 1 minus h square whole square plus 2 zeta h whole power minus 3 by 2 into. In place of h, we have this equation. So again, we want to differentiate this. It is also in the form of h square. 2 into 1 minus h square into minus 2h. 2 zeta is constant. So 4 zeta square into 2h equals to 0. These two terms are in multiplication. If we transfer the first time to right hand side, it will become 0. The remaining term is 2 into 1 minus h square into minus 2h plus 4 zeta square into 2h equals to 0. Minus 4h into 1 minus h square plus 4 zeta square into 2h equals to 0. Next, we will multiply 4 into 2. Minus 4h into 1 minus h square plus 8h zeta square equals to 0. Dividing with respect to 4 on both sides, we will get the equation, and again we want to divide with x. Then x square equals to 1 minus 2 zeta square. X equals to root of 1 minus 2 zeta square. We know that x equals to w by wn. Here we are finding angular frequency, resonant frequency, that is with respect to r. Wr by wn equals to root of 1 minus 2 zeta square. Wr equals to wn into root of 1 minus 2 zeta square. Here we are finding resonant frequency, that is 2 zeta square should be less than 1. If it is greater than 1 or equals to 1, it will become 0 and there will be no resonant frequency. So zeta should always be less than 1 by root 2. This is about resonant frequency. Resonant peak. It is the peak value of magnitude of transfer function. Before we found the equation for resonant frequency, that is at which point we will get the maximum magnitude. Here we want to find the value of the magnitude. Whenever the frequency is resonant frequency, we will get the peak magnitude. So we will use the equation, resonant frequency equation. WR equals to WN into root of 1 minus 2 zeta square. WR by WN equals to root of 1 minus 2 zeta square. We know that H equals to WR by WN. So H equals to root of 1 minus 2 zeta square. 2 zeta square equals to 1 minus H square. Substituting these equations in magnitude. Here we are finding maximum value of magnitude. So we will take the equation of magnitude. MR equals to 1 by root of, in place of 1 minus h square, we are substituting 2 zeta square. 2 zeta square whole square plus 2 zeta into root of 1 minus 2 zeta square whole square. 1 by 2 square 4 zeta power 4 plus 4 zeta square into root and square will cancel, 1 minus 2 zeta square. 1 by root of 4 zeta power 4 plus 4 zeta square minus 8 zeta power 4. 1 by root of minus 4 zeta power 4 plus 4 zeta square. Taking 4 common, 4 zeta square. 4 zeta square into 1 minus zeta square. 1 by 2 zeta into root of 1 minus zeta square. Resonant peak MR equals to 1 by 2 zeta into root of 1 minus zeta square. This is the final equation for resonant peak. Bandwidth. This is also one of the frequency domain specification. Normally, bandwidth is the range of frequencies over which system works satisfactorily. In this, it is the range of frequencies over which the magnitude of T of j omega drops to 70.7% from its zero frequency value. That is, magnitude of transfer function at omega equals to 0 to 70.7% of its zero frequency value. This is the magnitude equation. And first we want to find the magnitude at zero frequency value, that is omega equals to 0. H equals to omega by omega n. Omega equals to 0. 0 by anything 0. Substitute in place of H, m equals to 1 by root of 1 square plus 0, that equals to 1. At zero frequency, magnitude is equals to 1. Again we want to find the magnitude. They have given that it falls to 70.7%. So we want to consider the magnitude at 70.7%. M equals to 70.7 by 100, that equals to 0.707. M equals to 0.707 equals to 1 by root of 1 minus h square whole square plus 2 zeta h whole square. Here we are equating the equation to 0.707. That is, these both are magnitudes. The value of 0.707 is 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 equals to 1 by root of 1 minus h square whole square plus 2 zeta h whole square. On equating, we will get 1 minus h square whole square plus 2 zeta h whole square equals to 2. This is in the form of a minus b whole square. Get it in the form of a minus b whole square, that equals to a square minus 2ab plus b square. 1 minus 2 h square plus h power 4 plus 4 zeta square h square equals to 2. Taking h square common, h power 4 plus 4 zeta square minus 2 into h square minus 1 equals to 0. This is in the form of quadratic equation. The roots of quadratic equation are minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. In this, a equals to h, b equals to 4 zeta square minus 2, c equals to 1. Substituting the values, minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac, minus 4 into 1 into c equals to minus 1. So we will get plus 4 by 2, a value 1, 2. We want to substitute the values, and here we are going to simplify the equation. This can be written as this form, and here taking 4 as common, a plus, it is in the form of a plus b by c, that we can write it in the form of a by c plus b by c. On simplifying, we will get the equation h square equals to 1 minus 2 zeta square plus root of 4 zeta power 4 minus 4 zeta square plus 2. H equals to root of 1 minus 2 zeta square plus root of 4 zeta power 4 minus 4 zeta square plus 2. H equals to WB by WN, where W is the bandwidth. W equals to WN into root of 1 minus 2 zeta square plus root of 4 zeta power 4 minus 4 zeta square plus 2. This is the final equation for bandwidth.